secret what God can do.
I bring you greetings of joy in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I'm glad to welcome you again to today's opening prayer session, popularly known as Moment of Mercy. I want to briefly exhort us on the topic, "Every evil planting against you shall be uprooted." Our Bible reading will be from 2 Samuel chapter 11. I will read from verse 2 to verse 5. It says, "And it came to pass in the evening tide that David arose from off his bed and walked upon the roof of the king's house. And from the roof he saw a woman washing herself, and the woman was very beautiful to look upon. And David sent and inquired after the woman, and one said, 'Is it not this Bathsheba, the daughter of Eliab, the wife of Uriah the Hittite?' And David sent messengers and took her, and she came in unto him, and he lay with her, for she was purified from her uncleanness, and she returned unto her house. And the woman conceived, and sent and told David, and said, 'I am with child.'" My dear listener, I want to say this. Our life's journey to destiny fulfillment and eternity is associated with many characters that we meet on the way. Some of the people we meet in our life's journey are arranged by God to help us to fulfill destiny or get out of danger. Some are actually planted by the devil in order to use them to frustrate our destiny fulfillment. And the devil labors to do this more when it has to do with people who have been destined for greatness. I want to mention some examples before I pray for you. You remember the story of Joseph in the Bible. Potiphar's wife tried to lure him into adultery, but God gave him grace to overcome that temptation. Potiphar's wife was planted on the way of Joseph to greatness, to become the prime minister of Egypt. But God turned it around for the good of Joseph. You remember Samson, who was ordained to be a great judge in Israel, a great victor over the Philistines. But the devil planted the desire for women and planted immoral women on his way, like Delilah, who brought him down. In the portion of the scripture we read, we also notice that a beautiful young lady, actually the granddaughter of David's chief counselor, Ahithophel, Bathsheba, was planted by the devil or manipulated to take her bath at the time that David was walking around on top of the roof of his house, and that led David to immoral sin. Today, I want to speak over your life, my dear listener, by the mercies of God. Any satanic arrangement to lead you to sin and to failure and to have your great destiny aborted shall not succeed. Let me pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, the Son of the living God, I pray that you give grace unto all my listeners, grace to be victorious over sin, grace to walk in your wisdom and in your power over satanic plantings and arrangements on their way to bring them down. As they move about this day and in this season, let grace abound for them to walk in dominion. In Jesus' name, amen. The Bible says in Romans 10:11 that those that believe in God will not be put to shame. May shame be far from you today. In Jesus' name, Amen. Until the same time tomorrow, this is your brother, Bishop Maxwell Korie, saying God bless you. But do not forget that you can access other teachings and ministrations of mine by going to our YouTube channel or Facebook page. They have the same address, Lifeline Assembly Headquarters.